Now, to go from high to low or low to high, all you do is connect or disconnect the cable anchored to the bottom. So if I want to go from high to low, just use the upper pulley. If I want to go from low to high, I connect and I go from low to high. Switch to the middle. From edge to edge, 48 7/16. This particular power rack is 2x2 steel, so let's make sure it's actually 2x2. It is 2 inches by 2 inches on the nose, okay? So what we're gonna do is add 1/16 of an inch to that to give us 2 1/16 inch blocks, and that slight 1/16 of an inch gap is gonna allow for us to be able to slide this to the middle when we wanna use it, or slide it to the rear when we wanna use our pull-up bar. And then finally, we need a 5 1/8 inch of block to go from this edge to this edge.
This is the center line. It is 50 and a quarter inches from either direction, so it's dead center. What we're gonna do is go 3 inches this way, put a lag screw here, and go 3 inches this way, put a lag screw here. Okay, so we're gonna put it right here and right here. Okay, so we're gonna drill through and then drill through here. And we're gonna use 6-inch lag screws. We're gonna drill right here. So right here, we're gonna drill right here. Okay, we'll get that centered up, and these will go in and in. We have 2 1/16, 2 1/16, 5 1/8, 3 drilled all the way through, 3 drilled all the way through, and we have our lag screws. And essentially what's going to happen is we're going to go right in there with the other one right here, same deal.
cutting cable that's going to be anchored to the bottom anchors, you're going to want as little slack as possible. The more slack you have, the less range of motion you're going to have. So it's pretty much going to be a straight line from the bottom pulleys straight up to the carabiner up top. You'll notice that this cable has just enough slack in it to easily connect to the upper carabiner, but not too much slack so that we don't limit our range of motion.